Hello and welcome to Fact or Fiction, a show where we discuss what made the news this week and whether it was real or not. I'm Suyash Barve and with me is Jency Jacob from Boom. Hi Jency.
Hello Suyash.
Alright, to start things off this week, let's move to a story straight out of science fiction. Now, usually I try and make a bad joke or throw in a stupid pun into these proceedings, but for this one, I'm just going to read out the headline, alright? This is from the Boom News website, of course. It reads, Saudi Arabia did not behead its first female robot citizen. Jency, what the hell is going on?
In fact, many people did ask us that, isn't it very obvious that this is actually a fake news story?
Yeah, seems like.
But bring in Saudi Arabia into the picture, and many people actually thought that this is true. In fact, that's the reason why this had about 66 or 67,000 shares on Facebook. The story really went viral. Now, as we know, Sophia, it's the first robot to get honorary citizenship by any country. Now, this was actually unveiled by a robotics and an artificial intelligence developer in Saudi Arabia on October 25th. And that's when Saudi Arabia, which is so keen to actually bring in a lot of investment into technology, they said that they are bestowing honorary citizenship on Sophia. And after that, there was the story which went viral, which said that apparently many of the men in Saudi Arabia, they were so offended with this humanoid, and they actually that this mob tried to gang rape this robot.
The robot.
Yeah, the robot, and dragged this robot around the streets until the head got detached. Now this story, people really went sharing this. Now we went and checked whether are they saying it, this is satire, and that they're sharing this with certain jokes around it. But we found that people really took it seriously and they were sharing it in large numbers. Now that's the context to this. In fact, what we have found out is that this is a site called Duffel Blog, which calls itself the military version of the Onion. You know,
the Onion's a famous satire website.
And they are the ones who put this out. And if you go on their site, you know, we always say that please go on and check their About Us section, because there you will find out.
Usually it says satire parody website.
Yeah, they declare themselves to be a satirical website. Now they are the ones who put this out. They also manufactured quotes where they had men saying that, you know, that that we were quite offended by this, and that's the reason. But there's a very interesting aside to this. Several women in Saudi Arabia were quite offended by this. You know,
I'm sure this robot has more rights than most of the women in Saudi
Arabia. Yes, in fact, they said that, you know, that we have just about got the rights to drive, but she doesn't have to wear a hijab, she doesn't need to cover herself, men can travel along with her. And they were quite offended by the fact, you know, that she was getting so much respect and so much, you know, attention there.
So when the robot apocalypse that we've seen in Terminator and all these movies starts, it's probably going to start in Saudi Arabia, paces this. Alright, in case there was any doubt in your mind about the veracity of this story, and if there was, please seek help, we're calling it out as 100% fake. Let's jump ahead now to a story that's more about social etiquette than sci-fi. Jency, was the President of India snubbed at a wedding?
Not at all, Suyash. In fact, there is this video which is going viral where it shows IS officer Somanathan's daughter's wedding, and Prime Minister Narendra Modi was there on the stage. He was invited and he had gone there to greet the couple. Now, there's another gentleman who's standing next to the Prime Minister who people are saying it is President Ram Nath Kovind. Now, according to protocol, this is not how it should be, because usually you'll never see the President and the Prime Minister unless it's some event of national importance. You'll never see them at an event together, because there are several protocol issues there. You know, who should be first, who should be second. You know, so usually to avoid that, they're never there at one event together. Now, when we fact-checked this, we found out that the day when this incident happened, or this marriage reception happened on November 6th, both the Prime Minister and the President were not even there in the same city or in the same state. They were in different parts of the country. Also, the man whom they are calling President Ram Nath Kovind is the governor of Tamil Nadu, Banwarilal Purohit. and they look really similar. In fact, if you put in their images side by side, you'll find out that, you know, you could be mistaken, you know, that they're the same, that they're the same individual. That's the reason why we pointed this out on Twitter, and we said that they are not the same individual. They're in fact different people, and most people understood it, and they took off the tweets that they were put out.
So a simple case of mistaken identity. But just to be clear, I don't even understand why this is a story. Unless it's your wedding, you have no right to be offended about being snubbed. Now about the story, he wasn't even there, he wasn't even present, he was at another event, which we have proof
That's
of.
True.
This one is of course false. Alright, before we wrap up, let's go back in time to our fake news hall of fame. It's a segment where we look back on stories or people that have risen to the very pinnacle of fakeness. This week we go back to a fake story that refuses to die down, and a picture that's supposedly 60 plus years old that people can't stop sharing.
Right.
Jency, please tell me, why are there fake images of Jawaharlal Nehru on my timeline in 2017?
Right, in this week I can understand why it is on back on your timeline, because it was 14 November was Children's Day.
Yes, so that's the annual tradition of Jawaharlal Nehru hate.
So, so you know, now you have these images coming up. Now look at this image. Why would anyone believe that this image is actually real? You can make out very clearly that there is this image of girls who are part of a ballet troupe, and Jawaharlal Nehru has been photoshopped. In fact, when we went and checked the history of this image, we found out that this ballet troupe goes by the name Chorus Girls, and it was there in the US long back, and this image was there in some vintage photo, part of some vintage photos, and someone decided that he can Photoshop Jawaharlal Nehru into this.
That Nehru needs to be in this picture.
Right, he needs to be there.
There's
in this
a missing
picture,
piece in this picture, and it's Nehru.
And look at the text. You know, the text is what is so interesting.
Yeah, these quotes are phenomenal.
Right, and says that, you know, look at the lust in the eyes of this man, that even a dog will be ashamed by it. You know, so you know, someone has to really hate Jawaharlal Nehru to put this out.
You know what? It's character assassination, but it's top draw character assassination. Right. Like, really high quality
and there
stuff.
And there are several people who believe this. In fact, many years back, I've seen these images on WhatsApp, and I nearly believed it till the time I became a fact checker. So you know, now I really understand
sure,
you know,
a lot
why
of people,
I did.
A lot of people with their own personal biases believe it.
Yeah.
But of course, fake news is almost always about character assassination, Jency. But doesn't this cross a lot of times? Isn't this upsetting to see that someone who's been gone for several decades now, their character is still being dredged through the mud? Like, what is happening here?
Right. So here it seems to be that there is a political motive behind it. I would like to name them. BJP finds a lot of joy in actually trying to discredit Jawaharlal Nehru for many things.
Just generally the Nehru Gandhi dynasty, I think.
Right, the dynasty, and you may not agree with the socialist policies that he had and how he governed the country at that point of time. And many people genuinely believe that a lot of poverty that India saw was because of Jawaharlal Nehru's socialist policies. But keep that aside. Now, why would you be interested in Jawaharlal Nehru's sex life? You know, there are several other candid images that you see him along with several women, and that has been put out. Now, yesterday you had BJP IT cell head Amit Malviya putting out this, you know, collage of images of Jawaharlal Nehru, and he was trying to draw attention to Hardik Patel. And you know, the Hardik Patel
who himself is
CD.
Now embroiled in a sex tape controversy.
In a CD controversy. And he put out a text along with it saying that probably Hardik Patel shares the DNA of Jawaharlal Nehru. Now, why would you do that? You know, Nehru was your country's first prime minister. You know, why would you draw him into a political controversy? And he got trolled. Amit Malviya got trolled by several people who pointed this out and said that, is this the BJP's official position? Because let's remember, he's not an ordinary person. Someone argued with me sometime back saying that he is not a politician. But I would say he's a full-blown politician, because he understands what he's putting out. He knows what he's putting out. Look at the number of retweets he's got.
There's a tactic there.
There's a very clear tactic to discredit Jawaharlal Nehru and also the Congress legacy.
Right. So character assassination and mudslinging of the very worst kind. This image, however, is 100% fake. Alright, that's it for this week. You can find more fact checks on boomlife.in. You can follow us here and here. Also, if you see a story that looks dubious or you think might be fake, WhatsApp it to us on this number and we'll tell you whether it's fact or fiction. Thanks so much for joining us. We'll see you next week.